I do think I was always a contemplative, and I believe it must be a mystery that I can't completely explain. There seems to be some people who are, for whatever reason, deeply drawn to the contemplative life. And I did grow up in this church that was more centered on the word than on ritual liturgy and the contemplative tradition. And I read Thomas Merton's Seven-Story Mountain when I was in my 20s. And it was a revelation to me. And yet it wasn't a revelation at all. Because when I read about this interior life, and when I read about the contemplative life, I recognized it. It was the oddest thing. It was as if I had come home to something I already knew. So it was both a relief and it was an affirmation of something I seemed to know. Maybe our souls are wired in certain ways. There seems to be prophets and activists, and there seems to be the more contemplative, although I do think they're joined at the hip. I do think that if you are being a true contemplative, it opens your heart to compassion, and that if you have compassion, you have to have some sort of vision of the world that incorporates justice and inclusion and has this active component to it, which I've always had. But the contemplative experience has been the real base and core of my life always. And I don't know how to explain that really, except to say that in the deepest part of me, what matters is my connection to the divine, to understanding the presence of the divine in life and in myself, and being aware of that.